Hello, here we are again at La Fábrica, the old liquor factory I'm in the process of restoring. I know it's been a while since the last video, so there's lots to catch up on. Now you'll see the roof go on and the leaning tower gets repaired. Hopefully it'll stop it leaning anymore. You may remember the tower was an unusual construction with only three supporting sides. Well, the fourth wall was a flimsy affair, which has now been demolished, and a new stronger wall built up, firmly tied into the other walls. This moment was a bit of a big relief because the tower was at its weakest point just before the wall was rebuilt. At the top of the tower, a reinforced concrete ring beam was poured just before the new roof went on. I'm sure that'll guarantee we get another 200 years out of it. Whilst the scaffolding's up, we get a rare opportunity to see the skyline of Algar from an unusual vantage point. There's the dam in the distance, and a hodgepodge of old roofs, and a motley collection of old TV and radio areas, a typical Spanish village. And over there, they've just finished picking the last of the oranges in that small grove near the river. The walls have all been finished now and the roof is ready to go on. The first thing are the Scots pine beams, they're called Pino del Norte here, but not sure they're from that far north. Well, the beams have to be cut to size on site and treated with sort of anti-woodworm and fungus treatment and then lifted into position. It takes a bit of time to get the wooden roof beams in place. They've all got to be set out perfectly to match up with the roof panels that are going on top of them. And also it's not helped by the fact that the house is an odd shape. It's not rectangular, it's a bit of a trapezium. Well, the roof beams are on now and it's starting to get a feel for what the internal structure is going to look like. Before they've put the panel sandwich on. These are the roofing sandwich panels, a sandwich of extruded polystyrene insulation and waterproof chipboard on the top side. And then there are two types of finish underneath. There's a timber cladding, which will be seen under the eaves from outside in the garden. And then there's a sort of cement board finish, which can be painted white, and that's going to be in the interior of the house. Well, we decided not to go for the timber effect on the underside in the interior. It just looked too much like a sauna. There are a few panels missing, so the bedroom area had to wait till later, which shouldn't really be a problem in sunny Spain, normally. And then on top of that goes an impermeable membrane, which is stuck down, and then the roof tiles go on top of that. We used new roof tiles in the gullies, or the rios, and then we use the older tiles, which are more attractive, to go on the top, the sort of ridges, called caballón in Spanish. Unfortunately, before the roof was finished, there were a few days of really heavy rain. About 30% more than average for the time of year. Just typical. I shouldn't complain. We really don't get much rain. But according to Murphy's Law, the rain will fall heaviest when you have a hole in the roof. There's a hole in the roof, a rain's coming through. There's a hole in the roof, even thunder's coming through. Well, this is the bedroom area and it's still open to the elements, and although it's a lovely day today, this is where it's been causing a number of problems. This has
water's just been pooling here and seeping through into the shed below.
These old beams in the shed were on their last legs anyway, but the rainwater and the work going on above has just about finished them off. And parts of the ceiling are starting to fall in too. Anyway, they'll have to be replaced with some we've salvaged from the main roof. The water's even started to fill up the old wine fermentation bowl. It's full of old relics, but fortunately nothing's been ruined. The roof is now finished and it's all watertight. And obviously the forecast is now for endless sunny weather. On reflection, I should have had a word with the plaster icon of Mary. Maybe a few Hail Marys might have done the trick. Anyway, no lasting damage done.
It's a hole in the roof.